So in the series of the operating system lectures, today we will be seeing the layered architecture of the operating system. So what are the different layers that are present in the operating system? We will see one by one in brief in these lectures. So layered architecture is a great approach while designing the operating system. So in this, the layers are split into different, the operating system is split into different layers, and all layers perform different functions. So each layer has a different functionalities or a specific task to perform, and each layer can interact with the two layers, that is the upper layer, uppermost layer and the lower layer, just below it and the just above it layer. So if layers are selected in such a way that each user, function and services of only one lower layer can be performed, so and the change in one layer will not affect the another. So this is a basic diagram of the layered architecture while designing the operating system. So the lowermost layer is the hardware, then the process allocation multiprogramming, then the memory management, then the device driver, then input output management, then the user program and the operator. So this is a basic view of a layered architecture. So we'll see what are these layers in one by one in each brief. So the lowermost layer is the hardware, which will directly deals with the hardware part, and it is used to meant for the functionality of the input output communication. The uppermost layer is the connected with the application program, and it acts as an interface between the user and the operating system. So as we all know, user interface is used for communication between the user and the system or the operating system. So there are different operating systems in market which are being designed by using the approach or the using the design of the layered architecture, that is Windows NT. It is one of the earlier version which is using the layered architecture of the operating system. So while designing, they have used the different layered layers to perform different tasks. So what are the different advantages and disadvantages of this layered architecture? So the main advantages is that the change in one layer will not affect the other layer or the entire operating system. So it is very easy to design, and it is important that if any developer is making change while designing in one layer, it will not affect the entire operating system. So it is easy to test and debug the operating system because of the isolation among the layers. And adding new functionalities is very easy, and also removing the obsolete one or removing some debugs from the any specific layer is very easy, since all layers are isolated, so it will not affect one another. So the main disadvantage that we face in the layered architecture, it requires an appropriate definition of the various layers and a careful planning of a proper placement of layers. Since layers are independent, but it is important that which layer will be upper and which layer will be lower, and it should need a proper planning or definition while we are designing the layer, so that the change in one layer should not affect the other layer of the entire operating system. So this is the main disadvantage, but it is quite easy to debug and test this layered architecture, and also it is easy to remove one or more layers or add one or more layers to the operating system. So these are the advantages and disadvantages. So if we see in brief, it is quite easy to develop a layered architecture, and we can easily know what are the different layers in the architecture. So if we see the figure, I just want to explain the different layers, the operator, why the operator is used, user program. So hardware, as I told you before, it is used for the communication or the to perform different functionalities. Process allocation is to allocate the devices, the specific process. Next is the memory management. As we all know, memory management allocates the memory to the program or to the task. Then device drivers manages the devices, input output devices. Here input management is done. User program is the application program which will be interacted with the users, and the communication is done via the user interface. Okay, so thank you for watching the video.